and our own fears about what are happening in our own societies.
Tell Jarvis to turn on the TV.
My family's reaction to all this automation and Jarvis watching over them, it's a bit twofold, my wife and I. Like, we love it because it removes us as the bad guys from the parents. It's not us saying you can't play video games, it's Jarvis saying you can't play video games.
I'm sorry, but we cannot turn on the TV until the boys' room is clean.
It's creepy and it's weird. Unlocking your phone versus this entire government database.
Red alert. When we trigger red alert, it's almost like intruder alert, something bad is going on. It'll text all of our friends and send photos from CCTVs to them.
Inte bara våra städer, utan även hemmen håller på att bli smarta med internetuppkopplade lampor, element och lås. Ett smart hem kan styras på distans och effektivisera och underlätta vardagen.
So I say, hey, good morning, this is Matt, this is my journal entry, this is what I did today. And it actually sends that to the cloud for artificial intelligence processing. And so in the cloud, it actually does a full transcript word by word, as well as emotional and sentiment analysis. So it'll actually say if that journal entry was happy, sad. It also identifies topics and keywords. So as our family... For me, a smart home is a home that works with you, not against you. And by that, I mean, it should be doing things to make your life easier in an automated fashion, as opposed to kind of what I think of as old school is lots of manual things.
I en skyskrapa i Manila bor amerikanen Matt Farley med sin familj. Dagtid är han IT-chef på en bank. På sin fritid utvecklar han ständigt nya funktioner till sitt smarta hem.
We have a touchscreen here in the bathroom and it's the same Jarvis touchscreen control panel where we can see the weather, notifications from our phones, our calendar. This part right here shows my commute to work. It shows me that I have a 24-minute commute based on current traffic. And then we can also see the surveillance cameras in the house. They say that the best programmers are the lazy ones because they don't ever want to do the same thing twice. They write code to create things that will automate their life and make it better. We live a day and age when the collective human knowledge and intelligence exists on the internet. And so the next evolution of that is, okay, now that the data exists, the new layer of artificial intelligence is going to be able to harvest this data as needed.
I Manila har Matt Farley gått längre än de flesta smarta hemägare. Han har skapat ett sorts eget socialt kreditsystem som verktyg för barnuppfostran.
The smart home, which we call Jarvis, is constantly tracking which chores the kids have to do. The kids have to do those chores and check them off, and Jarvis awards them points.
Chore completed, Sunday kitchen cleaning.
And they can then use those points to actually unlock their video games, their televisions, so that they can't play or use those systems unless they've actually used one of their points.
Kids points update. I have added 1 point for Mason.
One of the main reasons I wanted to implement this was because we didn't want to be giving our kids free handouts. We didn't want to just give them privileges and give them money and spoil them, essentially. We wanted them to earn and work for these privileges and work for this money.
Tell Jarvis I completed the chore, take trash to curb Monday.
En sorts gamifiering av vårt beteende med tekniken som övervakare är nog ett steg som de flesta tycker är lite väl extremt.
What I wish you'd do is fly and let mommy get and let mom and dad let me play Xbox every single day.
My family's reaction to all this automation and Jarvis watching over them, it's a bit twofold. On one hand, they think it's very cool and they love it, especially my wife and I. Like, we love it because it removes us as the bad guys from the parents. It's not us saying you can't play video games, it's Jarvis saying you can't play video games.
Another one, what does Beethoven eat for breakfast? Oats to joy.
From the kids' perspective, it's funny. Sometimes they say, oh man, I don't like having to use points. I wish I could just play video games nonstop. But on the other hand, when they talk to their school teachers, they say things like, I have the coolest home ever. My dad's the coolest ever. So they brag about it to their friends and family.
Alexa, tell Jarvis to turn off the lights.
And I think the key there is they've been empowered. It's no longer at the whim of whether mom and dad are in a good mood to let them do something, to buy them something or play video games. They're now in the driver's seat. They control their own destiny. If they want to play video games, they can earn the points and they can do it and we don't stop them.
Facial recognition will soon be a security option at the Twin Cities Airport.
Jag märker dem inte.
Men oavsett vilken inställning vi har till teknikutvecklingen, vi kommer alla behöva förhålla oss till en framtid som blir allt mer datadriven och där de ouppkopplade och obevakade hörnen av tillvaron blir allt färre.
Through the CCTV camera, Jarvis is able to see with artificial intelligence whether or not the boys' room is clean or messy.
Alexa, tell Jarvis to turn on the TV.
I'm sorry, but we cannot turn on the TV until the boys' room is clean.
Okay, clean up the room. If you talk about gamifying society and social behaviors, I guess we could say China's the guinea pig. They're the first to go, and we can actually see how that turns out. The next generation coming after us, the concept of gamification is going to be much more natural to them, and it'll be kind of second nature to do things to win badges, to unlock achievements. I feel like the human race and technology in general is going to continue to evolve to the point where data grows exponentially, but then the tools that we have to make use of that data are going to augment our lives for the better.
My mum had phones when I was growing up, and my mum had wanted to put a tracking app on that phone. I would imagine as a 14-year-old, I would have been pretty resistant to that. I wasn't much older when I started sneaking out to nightclubs, but fortunately, I don't have a teenage daughter, I have a teenage son. He's not nearly as smart as I was, or naughty.